sort, it is important to know what rationalization of sort is. Now, rationalization of sort simply means multiplying the numerator and denominator by the denominator itself or by the conjugate of the denominator. Now, rationalization of sort is the stepping stone to division of sort. If you want to divide sort, we must know rationalization of sort. This sort has to be rationalized before they can be divided. And like I said earlier, rationalization of sort, or to rationalize sort, means to multiply the numerator and denominator by the denominator itself or by the conjugate of the denominator. Now, to divide sort, we'll be solving three examples on division of sort. Now, before we move forward to solving examples, let me explain what how it means to rationalize a sort. Now, in case here we have 2 over root 2, how do we solve this kind of sort? Now, we have it to be 2 over root 2 multiplied by root 2 over root 2, which is multiplying the numerator and denominator by the denominator itself. So here we have it to be 2 root 2 over root 2 times root 2, and we have it to be 2 root 2 over 2. Here we have this to be root 2. So in the case where we have 2 divided by root 2, we have it to be root 2. We have it to be root 2. Now, to move to division of sort, our first example is to divide 6 root 3. 6 over root 3. Now, what do? We rationalize the sort. Here we have it to be 6 over root 3 times root 3 over root 3. And we have it to be 6 root 3 over root 3 times root 3. And this gives us 6 root 3 over 3. So we have 3 here 1, 3 here 2. We have this to be 2 root 3. So 6 divided by root 3 gives us 2 root 3. Now moving to the second example where we have 7 divided by root 18. Now easily we can break root 18 down to root 9 times 2. And we have it to be 7 over 3 root 2. Now we multiply it by the conjugate of the denominator in this case. So we have it to be 7 over 3 root 2 times root 2 over root 2. And we have it to be 7 root 2 over 3 root 2 times root 2. We have this to be 7 root 2 over 3 times 2. And we have our answer to be 7 root 2 over 6. So we have our answer to be 7 root 2 over 6. Now moving to the third example where we have 5 over root 5. Where we have 5 over root 5. Multiplying it by the denominator, we have it to be 5 over root 5 times root 5 over root 5. So here we have it to be 5 root 5 over root 5 times root 5. Here we have this to be 5 root 5 over 5. And this gives us